We're going over everything you need to know about Charcot Marie Tooth and the newest updates starting now. So Charcot Marie Tooth, this is something I see quite a bit with an extremely high arched foot or what's called a cavus foot type. I see this in a lot of patients and there's a lot of great stuff we can do. But what's the origin of the name? It's named after John Marie Charcot and Pierre Marie and Howard Henry Tooth. They all independently observed the disease in 1886, so they shared the name Charcot Marie Tooth. Their observations were of muscle weakness, sensory muscle loss in the hands, in the feet, abnormalities of the nerves that they've seen on the microscope. So what is Charcot Marie Tooth disease? It is a hereditary motor and sensory neuropathy of a group of inherited disorders that impair peripheral nerves, those outside the brain and the spinal cord. So that's in your hands and your feet. Charcot Marie Tooth arises from genetic mutations specifically affecting the hands, the arms, the legs. So how do you know if you have Charcot Marie Tooth disease? These nerve disorders are very underdiagnosed. The symptoms of Charcot Marie Tooth can vary significantly between people, but generally these are the symptoms: muscle weakness and muscle atrophy. That means certain muscles are getting weak, especially around your ankle and your foot and the lower legs initially. Me as a podiatrist, I see a lot of Charcot Marie Tooth. This can lead to difficulties lifting the foot, causing something called foot drop, where essentially when you walk, you can't lift your foot and your toes drag and you can hit your toe. So do you trip quite a bit? Do your toes drag? That might be an option. Are you numb in your toes? If you took an ice cube or a feather and you touched your toes, and then separately you touched your lips, maybe you want to touch your lips first, then your toes, that's sensory loss. So I show this to a lot of people, especially with a tuning fork. They can feel the vibration on their chin, for example, but they can't feel it on their toes. That's sensory loss, and you can test that on yourself. So foot deformities, specifically a high arched foot type. So if your arch is high, if you have bumps in the middle of your foot right here, that's called pes cavus or cavus foot type. That doesn't mean your foot can't also flatten, but look at that ridge on top of your feet, and does your heel kind of clank when you walk? Ankle and knee reflexes. This is something we as doctors can test. And balance problems. Do you feel like you're always tipping over one side to the other? Do you sprain your ankles a lot? And also fatigue. Due to the extra effort needed to compensate for muscle weakness, this leaves you tired and sore in your feet and your ankles. The diagnosis of Charcot Marie Tooth disease. This usually involves a few steps, but number one, a medical history and physical examination. So all those symptoms I just said, we would take a look at. And it's usually pretty obvious based on the foot type, but you want to catch it as early as possible. It is a genetic disorder. Do you have a family history? Ask your grandparents, your parents, your aunts and uncles. Does anybody else have these problems and symptoms? We can check for muscle strength, muscle reflexes, and the presence of a very high arched foot type. A neurological exam. To assess for sensory loss, we can check with a Semmes-Weinstein monofilament, we can check with a tuning fork, and we can check for reflexes. If that still doesn't show a clear picture, we can get what's called an electromyography test, or an EMG, or nerve conduction studies. These tests measure the electrical activity of muscles and the speed of nerve signal conduction. Nerve conduction studies often show reduced velocities to the muscles of the foot and the ankle. And also now genetic testing. This, while not covered well by insurance for a lot of cases, is becoming more and more available and much more cost effective. This is something you can pay cash for, or a neurologist can do this for you. The exact type of Charcot Marie Tooth can be understood, and understanding the inheritance pattern and prognosis can be very helpful. A nerve biopsy. This used to be done a lot more. I think now with genetic testing, it's not as needed, especially the EMG and NCV studies. I don't think we need to biopsy as much as we once did. It's important to catch this as early as possible because there are things that you can do. Now there's two types, type 1 and type 2. The bottom line is they're both inherited. They're both genetic. This does affect your peripheral nerves. One reduces the impulse speed, causing muscle weakness and sensory loss. And the other does not change signal nerve strength, but you still do get weakness. So say you have Charcot Marie Tooth because you're watching this. What's the life expectancy and possible outcomes? These are improving. Charcot Marie Tooth is typically not said to affect life expectancy. People with Charcot Marie Tooth can expect to live long and productive lives. Now, I don't want to be unsympathetic because a lot of patients watching this might be having some significant problems, but statistically, it should not alter your lifespan. Although the condition can cause progressive disability and it can certainly impact your quality of life, that's what we're going to focus on in this video. The severity of Charcot Marie Tooth can vary a lot. There's a lot of different types, with type 1 and type 2 being most common. Here's what we want to focus on in our treatments. The key outcomes and considerations are, number one, mobility. As Charcot Marie Tooth progresses, you may require assistive devices. And what I like to focus on is orthotics, ankle braces. There are a lot of phenomenal orthotics and ankle braces. I link those down below. They are a lot cheaper than they used to be, but also walkers, canes. There are things called balance braces. So when you wear something on your ankle or a high top boot, it tells your brain that you have to react more. But if you're barefoot, you don't catch yourself as quickly. And they've actually done studies of people who wear an ankle brace and try and balance on one leg, for example, can stand potentially 3 times better and have much less ankle sprains or falls wearing something like a compression sock or a lace-up ankle brace. So that's such an easy thing. Same with an orthotic. If you have ball of the foot pain, front of the foot pain, an orthotic with a metatarsal pad, and I have all those below, that can make a huge, huge difference in taking pressure off the front of your foot. These are cheap, easy, and safe solutions. Daily activities. Adjustments may be necessary in your daily activities. If you can get a work from home job, for example, versus one where you're standing on your feet all day, that might be an ideal scenario. Or certain types of athletic events are much better. Like, for example, riding a bike rather than running might be a much better option, but you can still do a lot of different things. You might just have to change how you approach them. Pain and discomfort. Some people experience chronic pain due to joint stress or nerve damage. Peripheral neuropathy means you can get aching, numbness, burning, tingling in your nerves. There's a lot of solutions. There's a lot of great creams, a lot of medications, a lot of supplements, a lot of dietary changes. I go over all those for my peripheral neuropathy treatment guides. Some of them can actually make a really big difference, especially things like alpha lipoic acid, and there are a lot of other supplements. I go over those linked down below. And with any disorder, especially nerve disorders, there's social and emotional impacts. This can lead to psychological pain, depression, support groups, counseling, reaching out to a friend, having somebody support you, family, that can be really important. What's the new breakthroughs on Charcot Marie Tooth? Recent research into Charcot Marie Tooth focuses on understanding the genetic causes and mechanisms of the disease. And there are some notable treatments being developed. They're not quite ready yet, so there's not a cure yet, but gene therapy. Studies are exploring ways to correct the underlying genetic defects that cause Charcot Marie Tooth. For instance, gene therapy could potentially deliver a normal gene into the body, so that's possible. There's neuroprotective drugs. Research is ongoing to find medications that can protect nerve cells that can get damaged. There are clinical trials currently happening right now that can enhance myelin sheath repair and improve nerve signal conduction. And like I said, there's a lot of good supplements, especially things like alpha lipoic acid, that have really good results. So that might be something to consider. And there's regenerative medicines. Stem cell therapy may one day help damaged nerves, but it's not there yet. Are we close? I don't think we're that close with stem cells, unless something new's coming out after I publish this video or I miss something, and improving diagnosis and screening efforts. This is something severely underdiagnosed, but with genetic testing now, we can in the near future get much cheaper testing without needing a doctor's prescription to screen for these genetic diseases. This is becoming more and more possible. And if those come up, I'll have those linked down below, but we're getting close on a lot of these things. These studies aim to not only better understand Charcot Marie Tooth, but they are making meaningful impacts. I count down the 10 best treatments that I personally do for my patients for Charcot Marie Tooth. They are pretty effective, if I may say so. So check those down below.